Hello and welcome to the transcription explanation of these two designs. Now I'm going to ramble at you a good amount about the nature of these files I have sent you, as well as how I think that they could be quite editable and useful for when you make your final project on the Cricut for the poster or the shirt or whatever. Anyway, so first things first, I have sent these two files as separate things. This is the square design, and it is like a three vector file where I have each of these colors as layers, and this piece here is one full piece, and this piece here is one full piece, meaning all of the little red lines are actually touching somewhere. So this could be cut out of a physical object like a piece of paper and it would still work, and you could still get a nice 3D layer effect. And here all the black is touching, it's all one piece here, so I have like my little connector lines in here and in here, so that way nothing falls off. But of course, you know, you don't have to do it all as in one piece. You could just, you know, snip and cut and add like little circles behind here, do whatever you want with it. And then of course the background. And then this design is just done in two files. Well, two things that have the background and the foreground. Though both of these, I've also sent you my full vector working file, which are the black and white ones. And what's nifty about these is every single dot, every single line, basically all aspects of it, are things you can independently select and recolor, so you can make it however you want with however many layers and different colors you want, kind of like a coloring book, if you have a program that can edit SVGs, because this is an SVG file, which is a vector file. The program I'm currently using is called Inkscape, which is free and open source, and you can just download it and experiment and use it if you want. But yeah, these guys all separately colorable as well. So on and so forth. And then of course I have my little butterfly, if you want to do something with that. This is the butterfly I drew to go in the corners here, and this is an image, again, I drew, so you're welcome to make stuff with it if you want. Anyway, with that being said, let's get to the actual translation part of the video. Yay, I have rambled enough about the nature of these files. So these designs both say Amaya, the girl who dances with butterflies. And this word here is Amaya, and I have it again here. And you'll notice some slight differences, but still quite stylistically the same. I have the A, little guy outside the word circle here, the A here, the M-I, M-I-Y, Y-A-H. And these letters are made using this cipher, and vowels are these little guys. So an A is a little guy outside of the word circle. So this thick line here is our word circle for this Amaya, and this line here, this thin one, is the word circle for this Amaya. So our A's are outside of our word circle. Now reading order is bottom counterclockwise, like a time traveler going back in time. So that's why our first letter is at the bottom here. So here's our first letter A, here's our first little A there. And then we continue around. Our next set of letters is the M and I stack. Now letters with the same stem can be stacked, and anything in the same row has the same stem. So all of these letters plus vowels, vowels are these colorful ones here, are this deep divot stack, and then an M is in this row, and we have the M with the I together. So an I has a green line going inwards here. Color doesn't matter, but it's just showing that the line goes inwards towards the middle of our word circle, which is why this is an I and this here is an I. Then an M needs to have three line modifiers, and these lines count where they end on a letter stem. So if we zoom in, we see one, two, three lines on that M, and on this M we have one, two, three lines. Lines that pass through letters do not count, which is why this I line ends on the I, but doesn't go through, but doesn't count on any of these letters it goes through. So it doesn't count on the M, and it doesn't count on the H down here. So that's how the MI works. And you can tell the order because consonants are read before vowels. So the M is before the I. And then we have the Y. So this is a circle on the line of the word circle. So circle on the line of the word circle, and there are two dots by it, so it's in the two-dot column, so that would be a Y. Here's the two dots on this Y, and then we have the A outside the word circle, A outside the word circle, and then this deep divot, like a horseshoe or an omega, so we're in the top row, and there's one, two lines on that, again, one, two lines on that. So that makes it an H in the two-line column. So that would be Amaya, Amaya. And instead of putting, like, a period or any, like, kind of more normal punctuation around this, I try to allude to the punctuation with the phrasing. So here, clearly, Amaya is set apart from the sentence going around it. And here, Amaya is clearly set apart by having this sort of large sentence circle going around it. Plus, the one name Amaya takes up about a third of the entire piece. So, yeah. Okay. So let's get to the sentence of the girl who dances with butterflies. It's actually much simpler to read in this example, where I have a very clear bottom counterclockwise order. Here's the word the, here's the word girl, here's the word who, here's the word dances, here's the word with, and here's the word butterflies. So these are done in normal circle format, reading bottom counterclockwise, but these guys are all in one continuous sentence circle, so you read the letters in this order. So here, this letter, this letter, this letter, this letter, this letter, this letter, these letters, that letter, and that letter, and then continue on so first, so far, ugh, like this. So here we have a TH. It's a circle on the line of our word circle, so this row, and a column with no modifiers because there's no dots or lines on it. And then we have an E, like a little guy on that word circle. So the difference between a TH and an E is size. E's are small, THs are big. So THE. Then we have this deep divot, like a horseshoe or an omega. And there is one line attached to it. That line right there ends on it, making it a G. And then we have a line going inwards on our vowel. And that makes it, going inwards, green line, I. So G-I. And then we have three dots on the R. Three dots, shall it divot R. And then three dots on the L. So circle inside the word circle with three dots. So that would be girl. And then we have this W, one, two lines. Shallow divot, two lines is a W. Then we have a deep divot with one line here, that straight line, and that curvy one here. So just like the W. So it's in the same column as the W, except it is a deep divot, not a shallow divot, like a horseshoe. Not a bite taken out of the cookie. So the difference between these two stems is this is more than 50% of a circle. It starts to kind of like curve back in on itself and makes points, where this is 50% or less of a circle and does not do that. So we have a W, H, and then an O attached to it like a bead on a string. So that'd be who. And then we have dances. We have one, two, and then this third little dot, let me zoom in a little bit, is right here. And I put that there to kind of interrupt on the A to make it not a complete circle, because if you have a complete circle, the middle part will fall out if you decide to cut this out of like paper or whatever. So we have a D and then an A. Then we have a letter stack here. And these are two consonants because they're both bigger circles. So if this inner one were smaller, more like my normal vowel size here, like about the size of the black space inside it, then it would look like a vowel. Plus, vowels don't have the line passing through it like this, which is another hint that this is an N, not a vowel. So these are two letters that are stacked and are in the completed circle row, in this row. And we read, if there's two consonants, they're read a thin to thick. So our thin line here, the inner one, has one line on it, making it an N. And then our thick line has four dots on it, making it a C. Then we have an E on the line of the word circle here. I'm going to zoom in a scotch. And then we have this shallow divot like this with three lines making it an S. So that would be dances. And then we have a shallow divot with one, two lines making it a W. And then I have an I line going inwards and then a TH, just like this TH here. So with. And then we have our last word, a deep divot with no dots and no lines. So that'd be a B. A U has a line going outwards away from the middle. This is a double line, so it's a double letter. And unlike this double stacked letter, these two lines are the same thickness, which means it's the same letter twice. So same thickness is same letter. And these both have no dots and no lines, making them a double T. And then we have an E right in the middle of that, like this, this red one here. Then we have three dots on the R. And then we have three lines on the F. And here's a good example of a difference between an S, which is a shallow divot, and an F, which is a deep divot. And then we have one, two, three dots on the L, I line going inwards. And then we have something interesting happening here. We have an S with an E together, which would normally be S-E, but we need to spell it F-L-I-E before S. And that slash, this little line through the middle of our vowel, each slash through a vowel moves it up one letter in the stack. So that brings up this E in front of the S. So that would be an I-E. So the L-I-E-S. Because E is before the S, but the I is after the L. So L-I-E-S. E-S. And this S is done exactly the same as that S. So that's how this one says, the girl who dances with butterflies. And then this one, so we've read Amaya. Let me zoom in. We have a T-H-E, G with one line, I line going inwards, R with three dots, and then L with three dots. Then we have this shallow divot with one dot, so that would be a W-H, which unlike the other who I did a W and an H, whereas we can do a W-H as one letter with one dot. And then here's our O. Then we have one, two, three dots on the D, A outside the word circle. Here's that N and C stack. N is the thin one. You read thin to thick, so N, C. E, and then this shallow divot has one, two, three lines, making it an S, so dances. And then we have this shallow divot with one, two lines on it, so that would be a W. I line passes through it, so it doesn't count, but this is still an I. And then a TH on the line of the word circle. And then our last word here starts with a deep divot, has a U, so B, U, T, T, E, R, F, one, two, three lines, L, three dots, I line going inwards, E on the line of the word circle, and last but not least, a shallow divot with one, two, three lines, making it an S. So here we have Amaya, the girl who dances with butterflies. And it just follows this kind of zigzag up to down pattern. When you have something strung out linearly, you tend to find the center of our word circles, and then you read those left to right. And this one is the closest to being like directly on top of each other, but I kind of figured the path of this line kind of showed here. Plus there's a bit of context. Plus I wanted to fill up the square quite evenly and nicely to get a good looking poster for you. So yeah, that is the explanation to these designs. Feel free to let me know if you have any questions. And yeah, you download the files just by going to that email I sent and then clicking on the SVG files and downloading them. So yeah, if you didn't get that email, let me know. Thanks, bye.